The insert statement, or commonly referred to as the insert query, is the SQL statement that is used to add records to your database. There are two syntaxes for the insert statement, depending on whether you want to insert one record or multiple records into a table. We will cover both of these syntaxes in this tutorial. The best way to understand the insert statement is to look at an example, so let's get started. The first syntax for the insert statement allows us to insert one record at a time into the database. Here we have a table called Categories containing the following data. Let's write an insert statement that inserts a new record into the Categories table. We'll start by entering insert into Categories. This lets the database know that we want to write an insert query and add records to the Categories table. Next, we need to list our column names from the Categories table. These are the columns that we will insert values into. In this example, we will enter the category ID and category name as our columns. These column names will be comma separated and enclosed in parentheses. Now we will enter the values keyword. We will enter 150 and miscellaneous as our values. 150 is the value that will be inserted into the category ID column. And miscellaneous is the value that will be inserted into the category name column in the categories table. Because miscellaneous is a string value, it must be enclosed in quotes. Now let's run our insert statement and see what happens. The database will return a message to let us know that one record has been inserted. If we look at the categories table, we will see that the new record has been added. Now let's try out our second syntax, which is a bit more complicated, but allows us to perform multiple inserts quickly. Here we have a table called Employees with the following data. We also have a second table called Customers. Let's insert some of the employee information into the Customers table. We will start by entering Insert into Customers, which lets the database know that we wish to add new records to the Customers table. We will enter customer ID, last name, and first name as the columns from the Customers table that we will be inserting values into. Now, instead of typing the values keyword like we did in the previous example, we will enter a select statement that will be used to populate the records for the insert query. We will enter employee number, last name, and first name as the columns. Note that we have aliased the employee number as customer ID, but this alias is not required. When writing this type of insert statement, there must be the same number of columns in the select as there is in the insert statement, and the corresponding data types must also match. Next, we will enter employees as the table. And we will include a where clause so that only the records from the employees table, where the employee number is less than 1003, are inserted into the customers table. Now let's run our insert statement. In this example, the database will return a message to let us know that two records have been inserted. And if we look at the customers table, we should see our two new records added. This covers examples of how to use the SQL insert statement to insert a single record or multiple records. If you would like to see more insert examples, or would like to download the sample data we used for this tutorial, please visit our website at techonthenet.com. You can also try the examples in our SQL editor on our website. Look for the Try It button next to each example. If you found our tutorial helpful, please leave a like on this video. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more great SQL tutorials.